Let's talk more about respiratory infections, because they're very common, I would think.
Yeah.
And that is something that people are susceptible when they go to the ER. So amplify more on the respiratory infections.
Okay. So what I told you about tuberculosis and those small droplets is what we call airborne transmission. And they, as I said, they can travel for long distances and be transmitted to people that are very far away. Most of the infectious diseases that we deal in terms of upper respiratory infection or lung infections are not transmitted that way. They are transmitted what we call droplets, okay? And that's basically, once again, I'm talking to you, I'm producing, but this time there are also bigger pieces of saliva where the viruses, like influenza, like respiratory syncytial virus, like parainfluenza virus, all those viruses, even bacteria, okay, sometimes like pneumococcus, et cetera, where they are. And those are heavy, so they usually drop to the floor or to the horizontal surfaces within 3 feet of me producing them. So if that one, if I'm close to you, then I can transmit it. If I'm far away from you, I don't transmit it that much. So, but that's the way they can transmit it. But they're very easy to transmit, because also they can transmit it, but if I have a lot of secretions, and I'm sneezing, and I'm coughing, and I'm touching my hands, I can check your hands, I can touch something that you then are going to touch, and those things get transmitted to you. And then you touch your hand, and then you get it. So that's the way the most of the infectious diseases related to upper respiratory tract, like common cold, like influenza, or even pneumonias like influenza, parainfluenza, et cetera, are transmitted.